Hi again, Jonathan Walford here from the Fashion History Museum with Rachel Behling, our community outreach programming person. And we're going to go through another rack of 70s again. So more 70s stuff, and here we go. Notice the 70s bed sheets to go with it.
Oh, nice.
So to start things off, we've got a couple of sort of homemade things. This is a maxi coat done in crotches of jeans. And it was, we got it from a lovely woman who has since passed. She bought it on the streets of Amsterdam in about 1970, 71. On the back, it's got
denim
this.
Denim life.
For denim lifetime.
Oh, that's awesome.
Isn't that great?
Okay, this.
It's got pockets.
All the pocket expectations ever.
Yeah.
Isn't that? That's so great.
You what a, like bus tickets and dimes and that sort of thing. Yeah.
What a great upcycle.
Isn't that great?
It's so, it's trendy and it's
funky. That kind of latent hippie stuff.
Yeah. It's great.
And then here's another one we have, which is a maxi skirt with a shawl, been made out of a paisley shawl.
Lovely.
So not that I approve this sort of upside.
this here.
Yeah, that's all taken from the design of the paisley shawl. So they've looked at where the design works, and then trimmed it to fit onto the skirt. So.
Wow.
Yeah, I mean that was actually a good cashmere one too. So. A very good shawl when it was new, but it might have had a problem with it. It might have been a giant
hole. There might have been a hole,
so I can't get too snippy about that. So there you go.
There's always a story.
Okay, so there is always a story. These, you said you have the same dress in green.
I do.
You do.
It's great. It's really comfortable. It looks great on.
These are all these sort of these sort of trompe l'oeil, those two, and this one is Giovanni something or other in Florence, Italy. So it's taking off on Pucci. Giovanni or something like that. Anyway, so this sort of printed fringe, which is kind of cool. And then this sort of, what you call it, a Christmas tree.
because it's all in green,
right.
So I call it my Christmas tree dress. The great thing about all of this is it's easy to wash.
It is. And that's actually one reason why Pucci was so popular. It's also easy to travel.
Yes.
Because especially the silk jerseys, they ball up into something this size. So they're very popular with jet set in the 60s for traveling. This is a Pucci version here.
Very, very flattering on.
Yep, if you've got the figure. If you don't have the figure.
We all have the figure.
Now we go to France. This is Sonia Raquel. And it's pants with a long over, sort of almost like a 20s type of tunic top with the pleated. Isn't that nice?
Oh, it's really lovely.
It'd be very comfortable to wear, I think. Yeah. There's Sonia Raquel. This is Louis Ferrault. He's always a little more very mature woman.
Yep.
But good, smart, well made, tailored.
Pocket.
It's the 70s. Women have pockets now. Mm-hmm. They have things to carry. And here again, Louis Ferrault, kind of almost like a safari suit kind of look.
Belt.
It's a belted jacket. Very nice.
Again, you could wear the blazer with a trouser too.
You could. This is Yves Saint Laurent. I'm not really exactly sure when it's from. It's 70 sometime. I think maybe it's 74-ish.
Okay.
Be my guess. They'll be tweed. Michelle Roma. Goma, sorry. This might even be 69, 70.
Okay.
It's like right around there. Sort of a borderline kind of one. Lovely button. Yeah. And then Honey Mori. This really pretty silk dress with the matching belt. She's Japanese, but she works out of Paris.
Lovely.
I think she started quite early in Paris too. And then another Yves Saint Laurent.
Oh, nice.
This is getting a little more country peasanty kind of thing.
Really lovely. Really. Summer wedding.
In the south of France.
Yes. In the sunshine.
And Richard Carrier, Paris. Obviously inspired by Chanel.
Very much so.
Looks very much like a Chanel. It's even got the chain on the bottom of the jacket. And,
wow.
Yeah. That's definitely where the inspiration is coming from.
Beautiful.
And then I go to Canada. Wayne Clark.
Oh, yes.
And this parrot print skirt and blouse print.
That's fun.
Isn't that fun?
Yeah, yeah. A lot of fun.
And another Canadian Bagatelle, Margaret Godfrey.
Look at that.
His maxi skirt with the jacket, which you could wear separately.
Of course.
I'm doing your job now.
Yeah. I don't have to say anything.
Tivani, Montreal. Working woman's dress.
Really,
you know?
Cute.
Yeah.
Yep. From work to evening. And you've got lots of color and it's very personable.
There's some good prints in the 70s.
Yeah.
This is Pat McDonough.
Love and, it. Doing look at the trees. Oh, it's so pretty.
I think it's a cotton jersey.
Yeah, it's gorgeous.
Nice, isn't it?
Yeah, really love it.
Okay. And then we have Unicorn Boutique, Marilyn
Brooks.
Brooks, thank you.
Oh,
got records. This is her medieval dress from 72, I think it was.
Look at this.
Yeah.
So fun.
I told her that we had this, and I sent her a picture of it, and asked if she could give me a date of it. And she wrote back and says, oh, you're the one who bought it. So I guess it wasn't very popular when it was there.
Oh, I love it. And I wouldn't have put those two colors together like that.
The two greens?
It works.
I think it works, yeah. This we got from another lady when I worked at Bada. She wore it to work a couple times. I said, what is that tartan? And I realized it's the Olympic rings. And she bought it when she was in Montreal in 1976. This is for the 76 Olympics. And then she sent it to me years later when she didn't want to wear it anymore.
Piece of history.
Isn't that nice? Yeah. Oh, McD, hear more Pat McDonough. This is the label that she did in the early 70s.
Look at the colors. That's great.
Isn't that great? I love the little house
applique.
You said you had a similar one to this?
I have the same one.
The same one?
Yeah, and it was, I bought it from a school teacher. And what a great piece to wear with children. It's colorful.
Sure,
it's
like it tells
a story. Yeah.
Another McD.
And
sort of a weird boucle. Yeah, it is boucle, isn't it? Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. Great print again, like stained glass windows.
And that would keep you nice and warm on a chilly winter's day.
Algouettes, a Montreal label. This was probably a prom dress or something.
Just great.
Reminds me of those women who used to go around with the baskets of roses when you're sitting in a spaghetti factory.
But again, be mindful of flames. Candle flames.
It could end badly.
Oh.
Judith Clark, I don't know anything about her, but I thought this was interesting because of the furry arms.
That is so interesting.
Isn't it? Yeah, it looks like Ladies Who Lunch, definitely.
Yeah. You know,
that's definitely an important woman.
It's a piece. It's definitely something that you would remember.
And Creed's, good old Creed's out of Toronto. Great outfit. My mother would have worn that. She loved those dresses.
Well, again, that belt is a statement in itself, right?
And then do you remember that suede coat I showed you that had the waterfall on it?
Yep.
These are from Yolanta. So these are the things that she's doing. These sort of retro 30s, 40s style.
Oh.
Lots of velour, that kind of thing. So
this is gorgeous.
Isn't it fun?
Especially
I love her label, too. This.
Oh,
catch that.
Yeah.
Yolanta, Vancouver, Canada.
I have a few clients I have in mind.
Who
would love it? Who would love it? Or look very good in it?
And we got this as a donation. I thought it was kind of fun. I looked and I thought, this looks very 19... Yeah, these sort of dog ear collars are very 1970. I found it in 1970 Eaton's catalog, but it had pants originally.
The same pattern?
Exact same dress, but it had matching pants.
Woo!
So,
actually, it kind of goes with what I'm
doing. It does, very much so. Oh, it does, yeah.
I did not plan it.
Okay, now we're going to England. And this is...
Ginny Fortini?
Ginny Fortini, thank you.
So, are there pants underneath?
There are, like bloomers.
Oh, bloomers! Is that ever cute?
Again, I think this is 1970, 16 or 70, so it's like right on the cusp of the era.
So
and then
cute.
Zazie with hot pants, and hot pants I think are, they were, believe it or not, a winter fashion. They came out like in December of 1972
really?
Or something like that. So women were even in the middle of winter with the granny boots. So.
Well, there you go.
Yeah. And then another Gina Fortini. And she did Elizabeth Taylor's second wedding dress to
did
Richard
she?
Burton.
Wow.
Yeah.
So the first time?
The second time she they married.
Oh, second time they married? Or her second wedding overall?
Okay, no. That would be back in the 50s.
Oh, okay. I'm confusing Jonathan.
I think it was the second time she wore married Richard Burton.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. If I remember correctly. Which was like 75 or maybe the third time. I can't remember how she married Richard Burton. Anyway, there we go. Now, the ubiquitous Welsh suit. This was my mum's. She got it as a wedding gift, as a Christmas gift from my dad about 1974 or 5. I think
beautiful.
5, I think it was. She wore it to death. She loved it.
Well, you know what? They're timeless.
Yeah.
They're warm. They look great.
They're nicely made.
Yeah.
Yeah. And more from England. Bus stop. We actually have two. We have the woman who, wore these as well. They're identical, just one in the sort of muddy pink and one in black.
Look at this little peplum effect. I love that.
Isn't that great? Actually, this one doesn't have that. Yeah.
It's super cute.
Isn't that great?
Yeah.
Again, it's like 71-ish kind of thing.
Yeah.
Bus stop is really nice. Nice, fun label. One of those boutiques in Carnaby Street. And then this is also one of those boutiques. This is Janice Wainwright at Poland Street. So again, this may be a little near 72, 73, something like that.
This would make a great wedding gown.
It would.
You know, somebody who wanted something a little bit different.
Yeah.
A real statement. It's got a 30s
kind of flair. Even this kind of art deco.
Yeah, very beautiful.
Yeah.
Tall, statuesque figure, which I am not.
This is Jean Baron, or Jean Baron. What was the name of the designer who worked for Jean Baron? His name is escaping me at the moment.
This lovely tassel.
And this lettuce edging.
Gorgeous.
On the panels. Isn't that fun?
Yeah, very fun.
Yeah. Bates.
John Bates.
John Bates, thank you. Stephen Burroughs. This is American, so now we're going to the States. He's known for this color, wonderful color blocking kind of thing. Also from the States is Mountain Artisans. This was a collective of women who, this is the back of the dress, hang on, there's the front, who did quilting. And they did quilted like hostess skirts and then all sorts of things. And very popular in the
70s. Again, you don't get tired of looking at it because there's lots of color and pattern.
It is. Ozark couture.
Yeah.
Nice, I like it. Oscar de la Renta. This is sort of his gypsy inspired kind of thing. This is actually a peplum.
Oh, is it? Okay, yeah. It's not a cape.
Yeah,
so
that's
goes
the
like
peplum
this.
Over there. And if you hold that,
okay,
and then the sleeves have these sort of bishop-y sleeves.
There's the sleeve.
So there's lots going on here.
Wow, is that ever? I love that.
Isn't that fun? And then that's the belt that ties it all together.
Wow, and again, never mind, I won't say about how you could wear it. Oh, another way. But I love that overskirt.
Yeah.
That's a very 50s thing. Like they'd have the, or is it 60s where they have the dress with the little overskirt?
You're thinking of the pants with the overskirt that Audrey Hepburn had, maybe.
Something like that, but I've seen it with dresses too. It reminds me of that. Look,
also Oscar de la Renta. This is probably 79 or 80, came towards the end of the decade. Of the teething.
Yeah.
And this is Giorgio Santangelo.
I believe.
You don't really notice,
just Santangelo.
A lot of 70s is, you're very covered.
Yeah, it's true. Yeah.
Hi.
It might be tight fitting, but it covers a lot. Yeah.
Look at this.
Isn't that fun?
That's great.
Yeah.
A lot of these pieces really tell a story in and of themselves, whether it's the fabric or the design. Not just the label.
Right.
I think that's really interesting.
This is Victor Costa again. Another great print. That's the belt, yeah.
Great.
And this is Betsy Johnson.
I love Betsy Johnson.
Yeah. Isn't it fun
stuff?
This
is so great.
Not only she's doing cartwheels anymore, but her clothes are certainly fun.
I just love her clothes. Everything you've shown me that's Betsy Johnson, I love.
Now these you might recognize.
Ah.
Halston. And that's his most famous with the ultra suede.
And a little rough.
And a little known story of it. I used to know Beth Levine, who was the wife of Herbert Levine, who had the Herbert Levine Shoe Company. And she said that she was given a sample of ultra suede back in like 1969 or 70 or when it was first invented, and asked if they could use it in the shoe industry. And she looked at it and she said, no. And she gave it to Halston, Roy Halston, to take a look at it. And said, yeah, I think I could do something with that. So.
And the rest is history.
The rest is history. So that's where
that.
There's different stories, but that's what I heard firsthand.
I love this.
Isn't that great? His stuff is so simple, but it's very clever and it fits beautifully and it's comfortable. And so for the modern gal, works pretty well.
Well, and again, you can really accessorize well with something like that. It's a little bit more of a neutral. And then you wear a great.
Yeah.
A necklace or something with it.
Diane von Furstenberg, the wraparound dress.
The wrap dress.
She didn't invent it. They actually go back to the 1910s, but I mean, she revived it at just the right time, and it was very successful. And this particular print was very popular.
I can't, if I ever get wrap dresses in at Auburn,
they're gone.
Gone. Yeah. And it doesn't even matter if it's her. It's something that women love to wear.
One thing to be careful, if you do get them and it says it's washable, they're not washable.
They're not washable.
The dye runs. And then gunny sacks.
Oh, yes.
We've got more gunny sacks, too, but this was the prom dress of every girl I went to school with. So right through from about 74 to 79, I think it was like the classic prom dress.
And it's right back in fashion now.
Is it?
Gunny sacks is very popular.
Well,
what is it?
Terry cloth jogging outfit. And we have the runners that go with it.
Okay, so we go from the high neck
to very little.
To little.
Yeah.
Interesting.
You either show a lot or show nothing. Mm-hmm. And I thought this was interesting. This is worn for a run for now.
Wow.
The National Organization of Women.
Wow.
And we've got the little shorts that go with it as well. So we need the stance for the sneakers if we want that.
Yeah.
And then a couple of fun things. This is a Daniel Hechter, who's an off rack label, ski outfit. And then this, which we got donated,
Ski-Doo. I love it.
Ski-Doo Fashions. So Canadian fashion for being on a skidoo.
And it's like the court jester.
It is very much the court jester. And we even have like the little helmet that everything goes with it. So.
I don't want to try that on. That's one thing. Wow. But ski suits, you know what's great? To have that, it's nice and warm, except for when you have to go to the bathroom.
Oh, really awesome. Yeah, there's a lot to go
through. Yeah. Well, so there thank we go. You.
There's another rack of 70s. Done.
Yay.